Hi, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can insert and delete anything into your headers and footers. So firstly, to access your headers and footers, you can do this in two ways. Firstly, you can go up to Insert, go along to Header or Footer, click on the drop down and select Edit Header. To come out of the headers and footers, just simply double click in the center of your page. To go back into the headers and footers, there is another way, which is to double click at the top or the bottom of your page. So now you know you're in your headers and footers because the main body of your document will fade and be slightly greyed out. You'll also see the header and footer tabs and this blue line. Now, many people may think that whatever you put into the headers and footers has to be within this space here. But in actual fact, you can put anything anywhere in your page. It doesn't matter whether it's below this line, it will remain in the headers and footers and will be duplicated across every page in your document. So let's firstly do an example of a shape. So let's go to Insert, Shape, click on the drop down. I'm just going to select a rectangle and I'm going to click and drag out a rectangle. And immediately you can see that that rectangle is duplicated on every single page. Not only that, if I double click in the center of my page, you can see now the reverse happens. My document text is now completely black and my headers and footers are grayed out or faded in the background. You can also see that the rectangle is copied completely on each individual page. It's not just at the top section in the margins. So let's double click back at the top here. And we can also put some text in. You can see my cursor's at the top here. I'm going to have to move this rectangle down, but your cursor will remain here in your header and footer, and then you can just simply type. So you can add some text at the top, although I find that to be quite inflexible. What I like to do is to add text by adding in a text box. So if we go to Insert, go to Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. Again, you don't have to keep it in that margin range, although it will interfere with your text, but I will show you how to solve that problem at the end. So now I can just insert my text. I can move this text box and rearrange it and resize it. I can move this anywhere in my headers and footers. I can move this anywhere in my document. I can move it to the footers, it doesn't matter. I can put it to the left, the right, it doesn't matter. Now this text box, as you can see, has got a black border and a white background. To get rid of both of those, just select it, go to your Shape Format tab, go to Shape Outline, click on the drop down and select No Outline. Go to Shape Fill, click on the drop down and select No Fill. And you can see now that that box is transparent. And again, you can move that anywhere you like in your document. The next thing you might want to insert is a photograph or a picture. So let's go to Insert, Pictures. I'm going to use the stock images in Word, but you can choose one from your files. So I'm going to go to stock image. I'm just going to select this one here and select insert. Now, when your image is inserted, you can see everything goes wrong. So the main reason for this is you need to change the wrapping on your photograph. So all you need to do is to right click, go down to wrap text, and select in front of text. And now you can see that your photograph's been inserted, but it does interfere with your text. So let's just resize that photograph and perhaps put it at the top here where we may choose to have it in reality. Now, because my text is interfering with it, I do one of two things. I can either change the size of my image or I can come back into my main document, double click in the middle here, go over to my margins. You see these rulers here. If you can't see your rulers, go to View and then make sure rulers are checked. Go over to the rulers here and you see my cursor changes if I hover between the gray and the white section. Click and you can see a line appears. Drag that line down to underneath that image to where you want your text to start on every page. And that will solve that problem. Now again, let's go back into our headers and footers and I can insert now a table. So if I go to Insert, I go to Text Box, click on the drop down and select Draw Text Box. The reason I'm going to do it in the text box is it's a lot more flexible. So click and draw out a text box, go back up to insert, go to table, click on the drop down, select a table numbers you want for rows and columns, and you can see my table has been inserted. Again, if I deselect it, you can see the black outline of the text box. So select it, go to shape format, shape outline, click on the drop down and select no outline. Then I can place this anywhere, I can resize it, and then I can pop it anywhere in my document, double click back into my main document. There it is. If you don't want the text to go beyond that, again, you can go to your rulers and make sure that line is above that table so that your text will not go beyond this table. Double click back inside. The final thing I'll show you is the page numbers. So again, go into your footer. You'll be in the header and footer tab. Go over to page numbers, click on the drop down and select page number. You'll have this menu that will appear. Click on the drop down and then you can place your page number wherever you want it. There's further formatting you can do here. Once you're happy with it though, click OK and you can see my page numbers have now been inserted. If you want to change them or get rid of them, all you need to do is go back up, click on the drop down and select remove page numbers and they'll be removed. If I just zoom out, you can see my document. I'm going to double click back in to the main document. I can carry on editing my document. My headers and footers and all my text and images will be saved on every single page. And once again, if I want to delete any of this, I'll just go back into the headers and footers and simply select the item I want to delete and then press the delete key. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.